Determined to pursue their dream of statehood, Kurds rallied in Dohuk, northern Iraq, ahead of an independence referendum on September 25th. Refusing to bow to international pressure and opposition from Baghdad, Kurdish President Masoud Barzani has dismissed calls to cancel the vote. Some 5 million people are eligible to vote in Iraq's oil-rich, semi-autonomous Kurdistan region. Polls by local media show more than 80% favor independence. Neighboring Turkey and Iran opposed the referendum, fearing that it could encourage their own Kurdish minorities to break away. There have been protests in Istanbul, and the Turkish military is holding drills near the Iraqi border. Iraq's parliament says the referendum is unconstitutional, and the country's Supreme Court has ordered the vote to be suspended. The independence referendum comes after Kurdish Peshmerga fighters played a key role in pushing back Islamic State militants in northern Iraq. When the Iraqi army crumbled in the summer of 2014, Kurdish forces moved beyond Iraqi Kurdistan to defend the city of Kirkuk. Now, Kirkuk and the oil around it are in dispute, and there are fears Kurdish independence could trigger ethnic conflict. Tensions in the city are growing between Kurds and ethnic Turkomans. The United States and the United Nations have called on Iraqi Kurds to postpone the vote, concerned it could harm Iraq's continued fight against Islamic State militants. But there has been no such call from Moscow. Instead, Russian state oil giant Rosneft announced another major investment to help Iraqi Kurds develop their natural gas industry. That makes Russia one of their biggest financial backers, as the Kurdish independence drive in Iraq risks sparking a new crisis in the Middle East.